Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the IBSI webinar series. This afternoon, we have an interesting webinar with partnering with Explio. And this is basically on building sustainable digital capabilities, primarily focusing on banking and financial services. Speaking of banking and financial services, now digital is no longer a project or an initiative that most banks are undertaking. Now it's become a way of life. Banks are adapting themselves to ensure the digital capabilities are being built in and being supported by all aspects and all departments and all units, technology across banking, so that the customer experience and the user experience is improved vis-a-vis the competition. Customer experience is an omni-channel experience and gets the best out of the capabilities that the bank is able to provide. The pandemic probably provided the last mile push that digital required to gain acceptance. And post that, most customers have got comfortable using the digital capabilities and taking it forward from there on. So today we have a very interesting panel and two experts in the field, and I'll introduce you both. From MasterCard, we have Amitabh Khanna. He heads the customer delivery for South Asia region. He's been part of various payments related companies and also part of banking and financial services industry. So welcome, Amitabh. Good to have you here. And leading the site from Explio and presenting to us some of the key aspects of digital capabilities is Raja Sundaram. Raja is a veteran in the fintech industry. He spent many years in key companies like HCL and Infosys and Standard Chartered before joining Explio 7 years back, where he heads the quality engineering team. So Raja, welcome on board too. Just a brief introduction about myself. My name is Murtaza Sheikh Ali. I'm the associate partner at Cedar IBSI. I primarily look at the financial services and the fintech side of the practice. I am a banker by profession too. I've spent many years between banking and consulting. So logically, I've stuck on to financial services, even in the consulting side of things. So that's a little bit about me. So how we'll basically place this 1 hour is, we'll start with Raja. He'll give us a good introduction in terms of the digital capabilities and the journey Explio has seen over the past few years. Amitabh is here to provide us his inputs and answer queries as we move along. But just before we start, I will start with a poll question so that it gets everyone thinking so that we get some inputs before Raja starts his presentation so he can also structure it accordingly. So I'm just launching the poll question and I hope you all can see it. I think the panelists can answer that too, so that's not an issue. The basic question we're asking is what basically signifies or where is your organization at in the digital transformation journey? Have you just started? Are you about to start the implementation, or are you midway through the journey, or have you done the first phase and now you're looking to improve, expand on the digital transformation journey? So this will give Raja a good head start into as he moves along his presentation. But as I said, I mean, there is no end for this journey. I mean, there are various journeys. You end one and you start another in the digital framework and digital process. So I hope you can see the results. Basically, the most, well, I was expecting the third option to be the overbearing one, but a lot of organizations seem to have completed at least the first phase of the journey and now looking to see how they can improve and expand. And a lot of organizations, of course, between the two, they're almost 70% are midway through the digital transformation journey. So Raja, I hope this gives you a little bit of a feel in terms of where the participants are in the process.
Yep.
As you present some of the key findings and aspects where Explore is helping the sustainable journey. So I'll hand it over to Raja.
Sure.
Welcome on board. And we'll keep this an interactive session. So as there are queries coming in and as I have any queries, I'll raise this to you and Amitabh and we can keep this nice and interactive. So over to you, Raja.
Thank you. Thanks, Mutal sir. Hope you are able to hear me.
Yes.
Yeah. Can. Very good. So it's clear. So thank you and welcome to this excellent webinar on Explio's capabilities and also the digital transformation journey. So we believe in walking the talk. So we have to be a pioneer and to be a good consultants in terms of digital, we ourselves have to walk through the fire and we ourselves have to go through the digital journey ourselves. So Explio started, we started our journeys 7-8 years ago and we started implementing the services, digital services, bringing our own services company as a digital company and coming across as a good digital trusted partner. So now today we are a trusted partner and among the top 10 quality assurance services companies in India. And we are recognized as a leader in next generation digital software testing services by Nielsen Hall. And we are in a challenger position by Gartner. And we are a very good thought leader in terms of technology services and also domain-led QA services, especially when it comes to BFSI. And the interesting facts are that 87% of our customers are repeat customers. And 96% we have the customer satisfaction overall. Of course, we have a lot of challenges that we face through in the digital. So you certainly need a trusted partner, and that's where Explio, we have been helping our customers. So in this webinar, we will walk you through what kind of engagements that we have been on in the QA and QE space in BFSI, and how we have been helping our customers in the digital transformation in banking and financial services and insurance. And overall, if you see, we are a public listed company in India, and it's Explio Solutions Limited. We are trading in NSE and BSE, and we have more than 70,000 stockholders for responsible for. And we have more than 30,000 game changers. Overall, we have been working on more than 30 plus countries, and with 15,000 plus game changers employees all around the world. And let me just quickly go into the services line. So we help our customers in the business transformation, operation excellence, and also in the support. So from the various different aspects of understanding the customer's business requirements, doing technology and transformation consultancy, digital transformation, actually helping them in various different areas of how do we onboard them from a simple DevOps implementation to IAC, which is infra support, or continuous quality, continuous automation, continuous development from to implementing some of their services, helping them in terms of their development of digital services, RPA, IPA, and also in low code, no code, MXDP, multi-experience development platforms. These are our bread and butter that we have been doing. And today we will focus more on the QA and QE, and especially in terms of how we are helping our customers in the digital journey from the perspective of QA and QE. So let me just quickly get into a deep dive where we have been helping our customers in terms of setting up innovation labs, advanced UI UX capabilities, providing services related to UI UX testing as well, development, cybersecurity, and also performance engineering and related to IoT and IoT related services, edge computing services, various different automation services. We provide customers complete automation services, digital automation services, plus the various different testing from the product testing, PLM and PLM related test testing, digital twin as well, using solutions like Signavio, Enterprise Architect and Model.io and Test Modeler. So various different solutions using digital twin and creating a digital replica of your business and helping to identify the problems earlier than they typically happen during the production. And also in terms of customer support, especially when it comes to being providing L1, L2, L3 supports for the customer in terms of their software development and also in terms of testing, monitoring and maintenance services. So we provide the whole nine yards and the entire say spectrum of quality and related services to our customers. And we started now with the development solutions as well, system integration for especially, we are a boutique system integration company now where we are providing system integration services for our customers in the BFS area as well. We started this journey last 3 years back. And we have been supporting customers like fintech customers and education customers, various different services related to software development and also conversational technologies. When I say conversational and exponential technologies, I mean chatbot and various different conversational UI, intelligent chatbot using IBM Watson or simple Watson Assistant or open source dialogue flow and adaptive cards and various different chatbot services and stuff like that. To do all these things, we have to, first of all, do all these ourselves first and implement these services. So we started walking through the path that we wanted to say help our customers. So we developed our own chatbot for our HR chatbot, and it's already live. And we have developed our own solutions for our onboarding experiences, digital onboarding experiences, RPA solutions. We started using RPA for our own services before we support the customers. So many of these Intel initiatives and software development, application development, test tool development, and also this conversational AI development into deepfake technologies, various other conversational technologies helped us to confidently understand the customer's problem and confidently face the customer and also ability to help them through in their digital journey. So let's walk through some of these services what we have been providing. We have actually defined these services in various.
Just one sec, Raja. Since we are starting on some use cases, before that, Amitabh, so that he's also engaged. Amitabh, you spent many years in the payments area across, and obviously payments being the amount of automation involved in payments and the amount of digital aspect in payments, obviously that requires continuous level of testing on some parameter or other, because there are new features being rolled out at a really rapid pace in this industry. So what, I mean, you've been there in the industry many years. So what change have you seen in the QA/QE space over the past? What are you seeing over the last 2 years, say, for example, of what you were seeing, and what has been the real change which has helped you or the industry per se in payments?
Sure. So obviously, I mean, whether technology or operations, the technology is evolving. So if you need to be efficient, I mean, you need to continue to doing automation, very rightly pointed out by you. And this phenomena, something which I have been personally experiencing, I'm sure everybody on the call would have been experiencing as well, has been happening for say about last 7 to 8 years. But the pace with the changes are happening in the last about couple of years, specifically, I would say from 2019 onwards, is been, I mean, at a very different pace altogether. And the primary reason is that, you know, the entire banking or the financial network, the way they were positioned all this while, fintechs have really come in and they have really disrupted the way the changes or the technology changes were happening. And the advantage which they obviously have is that they are leading on the new technology. They do not have the legacy platforms or technology to worry about. Right. So things can happen pretty fast for them. Now, specifically from a validation perspective, which is what the QE or the quality teams kind of provide you before I would say anything else, sort of, is something becomes very important, because something which is like a proof of concept has to move into real world. And the testing of that, I would say, or testing waters of that in terms of needs to happen very, very specifically before you actually take it to the real world. So I think the changes, if I can say, is in terms of, you know, one, we see a lot of companies spending huge amount of time in terms of upskilling their human resources, keeping in mind that this is something which is going to be important for them. The second thing which I see is a lot of trust has been built in terms of partnering with organization who specializes in testing for something, so to say. So in some way or the other, I mean, it's so been getting designed now that, you know, we focus on development, we get somebody else to test it and then take it forward to the market. I think that's a big change which has happened. So rather than, you know, relying or building everything of your own, collaboration is something which is happening. And that's something which I see a very, very positive sign.
Okay. So Raja, basically that's what the industry has to say. Obviously, testing also has become quite a specialized field.
Absolutely. In terms
of what type of testing you are doing. So it is whether it is the UAT or the security or the penetration or whatever.
Yep.
And nowadays you have, you know, specialized companies even for these small pits. Some of the large ones obviously offer the full spectrum. But sometimes you see companies even going deeper into each particular area. Yeah.
So every aspect of testing has become today a niche, and everybody is, you know, who's specializing in that niche is looking forward to put their hand forward and say, this is, I can do better for you. And again, as I said earlier, organizations are looking forward to capitalize on that expertise, which people have built, and then take it forward, basically.
Super, Amitabh. Thank you so much for your view. Raja, you can.
Yeah, very valid points, Amitabh. And that's precisely what we are going to discuss today. How basically testing is playing a huge role, or validation is one of the paramount tasks today, because a lot of development integration happens, and certainly the customers end customer experience needs to be properly validated. Not just the application is working properly, but also it behaves well during the production, so it doesn't have operational issues, operational challenges, or scalability challenges, or security issues, and stuff like that. So in the couple of slides, we will see how we have been helping our customers in terms of this QA/QE engagements, and how we are able to help the customers when it comes to speed to market, and also quality of product on time. And one such case is that where we have been working with one of the Saudi Arabian group insurance organization, where we have to develop a lot of, regression packs, especially using JMeter and Groovy. And this is where actually JMeter and Groovy is not a very usual combination. JMeter and Java is typically a combination. But we had to develop a lot of Groovy scripts. And unfortunately, since the Groovy testers are not much in the market, there's a great chance that the validation, there's a good chance of like errors in the script itself. So we wanted to ensure that we develop a good software to the customer. So in that attempt, we went towards innovation. And when we are pushed against the wall, we innovate. And if necessity is the mother of innovation. We innovated this FuseJ. We are proud to say that it's the very first framework for performance testing. Typically, people develop frameworks for automation, and we do have good amount of automation frameworks, especially continuous integration, continuous testing, and stuff. But this is the first time that we realized that we have to do a lot of scripting in Groovy, and we need to ensure that consistency and standards across the scripters, and we need to ensure that the proper traceability and proper, accountability in terms of who did what and how they did it, and the standard checkpoints, checks and balances in terms of assertion points for Groovy, so that we develop a quality software to the customer. That's where actually we have developed this solution called FuseJ. And this FuseJ solution is developed on the, that's basically the challenge. That's basically we have to develop more than 3,000 plus scripts actually for this customer, and in a very short time. And you can see that this is the team size and stuff that we started. And the main challenge is basically we were pushed against time, and we have to deliver good quality work in time. And that's where we developed our own framework called FuseJ, which can do the script standardization, do the automatic assertion, do the automatic performance analysis. Because one of the reasons that we have to use this Groovy and JMeter, because though it's an automation project, we wanted to use both automation as well performance. We wanted to reuse the same script, so that we can speed to market and reduce the time for separate performance test scripting, that effort we can save. So we went with JMeter and Groovy, and we developed this automation, validation framework, or what do you call as a assertion framework, which takes care of the automated scripting, augmented scripting, which augments the manual, script when people write the scripts, it augments the additional checks and balances, and ensures that the quality is maintained and built within the script itself, so that we can reduce the amount of time in terms of reviewing and fixing the script and reworking on the script quality, so that the scripts are seen and the scripts are standard across the board. So that's something that come out very well and very well appreciated by the customer. So we call it Fuse J for the lack of better words. And because it's a fuse of JMeter and Groovy and Java, so we developed this solution to speed up the whole thing. And the benefits are very visible to see. We were able to save 40% reduced effort in terms of scripting. And we could achieve the ROI within 40 iteration of the execution itself. And that was a very good, a very well received. And we're really happy that we were able to help the customer and could create good repeat business from the same customer. So this is one area where actually we used the performance testing solution like JMeter and developed our own say framework called FuseJ to help customer to time to market, speed to market, and completed more than 3,000 plus scripts within 2 months of time. And that's something that was actually not just only the test automation part, but also we helped them in terms of creating a goal copy database using Delphix tool. So very good test data management solution. So we use this Delphix tool to implement the goal copy solution so that because performance testing, as you need huge amounts of data, and we're able to achieve this with the Delphix solution. And we both completed both the test automations and also this test data management together on time and with a good quality, and the customer is happy. So this is one customer journey I wanted to explain.
And just one quick question, yeah, for Amitabh. Amitabh, so you said, you know, now obviously as a large organization, you all are looking for long-term partners across every you know, QA area that you utilize. I mean, besides QA, where you get an okay to move ahead, your you know, your delivery or your go live part is being tick marked. What is the other expectation that you all typically would have out of a QA partner from an organization standpoint? What would you also look at besides obviously certifying that the last mile has cleared and you're good to go live? What would a typical organization, payments organization, or even a typical financial services organization expect out of a good QA partner?
Yeah, so I mean, obviously, I mean, MasterCard, I mean, you know, this is a payments technology company, as well as we have a franchise as well, which we run, right? So keeping in mind that one of the things which you already mentioned, but I would still repeat that, is the validation. So QE, the most important thing, whenever we talk about quality, we look forward that whatever we bring to the market is something which is thoroughly tested, acceptable in the market. So that validation plays a very, very important role. Because one of the biggest things which we run on is, I would say, our reputation and something which is scalability, which we can work upon. So I think that's something plays an important role. And obviously, validation can do good or bad in both perspectives. So that's the first thing. The second thing for us is on the time to market. So in today's environment, when everybody is trying to be first in the market, trying to be at a shorter duration as possible. So that plays another important role in terms of ensuring that we have the right set of people who can work with us so that the things which are getting developed could be tested and then obviously, you know, bring it out in the market. The third thing, which I would say is, I mean, in a way, is the scalability part of it, because, you know, we work in multiple geographies, we work across, you know, different customers, a large set of customers. So the probability in terms of, you know, we looking forward to scale a small thing to a large thing in a very short span of time plays a very, very important role as well. So I think those are the three factors which I would say which influence a lot to us. In the recent, I would say what we have actually done is I don't know whether I have time to say that, or maybe I can hold this file for a while and then I can come back in a while.
No, you can say, and we'll, if need be, we can come back to it in detail.
Sure. Later. Yeah. So I just quickly want to summarize, you know, what we are actually looking forward now to do is, I mean, most of you would know that we are actually a B2B2C company. Yes. So whatever we allow our customers to integrate with, we want our customers to test that as well. And, you know, that is what we look forward to certify and say, yeah, you're good to go to the market, basically. So the products which we are integrating, that can be offered to their customers also. So what we have realized over a period of time is that, you know, every time whenever a new product is introduced, there is time and, you know, I would say resources which are required, both in terms of human as well as monetary resources which are required to test end-to-end to take the product to market. Also. And that eventually becomes a barrier in terms of when you're fighting with time, I mean, or when you're looking forward to have a short span of time to go live with something, that becomes always a challenge for us to address. So what we are looking forward to do is to see if we can, you know, bring our new system wherein we can offer a partner who could do that validation on behalf of the customer. So it's like an on-behalf service which has been offered. And again, it is across the globe so that our partner, which are banks, financial institutions, fintechs, whoever is looking forward to offer MasterCard services, take advantage of it. They don't need to spend time on resources and other things on every time whenever we go forward to launch something new with them. They just kind of, you know, utilize our partner's capability and, you know, build on that sort of thing.
Super. So Raja, more feedback in terms of customer expectation.
Thanks a lot, Amitabh. Yeah. That's very good stuff. And we have been helping MasterCard in terms of the similar lines what Amitabh has been explaining, that we have been helping in terms of certification framework testing for MasterCards, ensuring that every customer is actually MasterCard customer is ensuring they follow the compliance framework, the task framework of MasterCard, complying to the security and the EMV program, and also the complete onboarding of customers, MasterCard end customers. So we do the certification testing, full-fledged certification testing we have done for MasterCard. We are proud about it. Thanks a lot, Amitabh, for that opportunity. So next one is basically where we have, I just wanted to walk you through this capability, and we have done a fantastic work for one of the customers in Philippines. It's a leading bank in Philippines, and where we have used the RPA solution like Blue Prism and Python, and basically Python-based algorithms to do the complete AML stuff. And we have done this basically for using this Python-based solution to develop the onboarding of customers from the STRs. As you can see that we had this STRs, which are actually suspicious transaction records. And then one of the major requirements from the customer is basically before the customer is onboarded and KYC forms, the customer wanted to ensure that the suspicious transaction-based customers are taken out from the system so that we get a clean cut KYC and we do not actually use or we do not allow the AML customers. So what we have developed is the solution using this Python-based solution, where we have come up with this entire, as you can see the mapping of using multiple different, 18 plus parameters, we have done this classification algorithms and stuff. And then we arrived at the overall specific identification and classification of the specific AML customers and outliers, so that we could actually clearly spot out that this is basically the customer that's actually done the AML transaction based on various different specific indicators. And that's been actually helped a lot to customer to do the overall removal of all these various different customers who are AML-based customers. So this is basically using Python and stuff. This is something that we have done for a Philippines-based customer. So similarly, we have done a RPA-based engagement for one of the customers in Europe, and where we had actually to one of the major requirements in the RPA side is basically how we can actually convert our workforce into digital workforce and reduce the human dependency and increase the digital workforce, so that some of these challenges related to human shifts and stuff, and also challenges that are related to the manual processing can be reduced. And this manual workforce can be used for better purposes instead of just doing some sort of like clicking an approval button or validating things, form validation and stuff. And all these backend processing, how can we automate using RPA? And that's where actually we have developed this RPA-based solution using Blue Prism for one of the insurance giants in the Europe. So for this customer, what the main objective was basically to convert the workforce into digital workforce. So instead of humans, we wanted to develop the bots and the bots to do the actual action so that the humans can do better job. And they can actually be put into a different, better work environment. So in this way, we have actually developed this digital workforce. The customer benefits are that the customer was able to understand and appreciate the work that we have done. And it's because they translated into the reduction of the requirements in terms of manual labor and it was all basically the bot run rate was actually increased from 4.7 to 6.1 FTEs. So we were able to replace and do more of automation. And it was $4 million saving for the overall over the period of the next 3 years and this projected. And basically, the, one of the best thing is that this process helped us to avoid the human errors and manual glitches and missed processings and various other associated risks, and also increase the full audit trail of the process and reduce the operation risk actually. So this is one good solution where we have implemented using RPA to help the customer to convert their workforce into digital workforce.
Okay, Raja, before you move ahead, we'll just have another poll question since we've covered some of the ground on the digital journey. And I'll just launch the poll question now.
Okay, sure. Yeah.
I hope you can all see, but I'll just read it out in what in the participants' view is the key challenge during any digital transformation journey. Is it meeting the regulatory requirements, which can be quite challenging in most cases, ability to obtain relevant digital skill sets, which we spoke about, defining customer journeys and user experience, or ensuring the customer and data security at the end of the day. While so while we customers vote or poll on this, there is a question for Amitabh from one of the attendees. Amitabh, in the payment space, what the participant is asking, there are multiple messaging standards which need to get tested. And in your experience, what challenges have you faced in automating this space?
Again, as I said earlier, I mean, messaging or, you know, the exchange protocols are not really a difficult thing to manage. What is important is in terms of, you know, how do you scale up the testing which needs to be done. So I think that's something becomes a kind of, you know, very, very relevant thing. For us, the use cases in terms of, you know, how do you scale up on the use cases, testing is something which becomes a real challenge, and which is what, which I was alluding earlier in terms of, you know, ensuring that you have the right sort of people who have the a continuous skill set upgrading program available within the organization, and then look forward to have partnership with the right organizations who can do validation on your behalf could really help. I think those are two things which kind of plays a very, very important role.
Thank you, Amitabh. We'll just take a look at the poll responses. So what you said actually has come out quite true and relevant in this is in terms of obtaining the right digital skill sets. And for you, it will also be building the library of use cases and so on.
Absolutely.
And so forth, and being able to use it. And of course, the UI UX and the security aspect is a close second and will continue to remain, especially security.
I mean,
I'm sorry.
I was just saying that, you know, actually the all three of them are very, very important in today's environment, right? So obviously if you have the right skill sets, you can really work on the other two, but I would say the all three of them are very, very important. And I don't think it's very difficult for anybody to rate them in terms of priority, which is first and second.
I agree. Yeah, absolutely. But the point is, if I give an option, we have realized all of the above, it's easily chosen, you know.
Yes.
So we try and make people choose one. So thank you so much, everybody, for participating. So there you go. Raja.
Thanks a lot.
Skill sets is an issue. You have also alluded to it.
Absolutely. See, this is one, as you see, that one of the major requirements for this customer was also doing the upskilling so that we just help the customer to scale up to enable the extension to the advanced technologies so that we do not just only do the RPA, they can actually be trained into IPA and Python and related stuff as well. So that's one thing that we have to do for this customer. So similarly, in this one where we have this, one of the major US customer, we help the customer in terms of not just only the onboarding and dockerizing the complete solution, all the applications, but also help them in their complete digital journey from the barebone machines, normal barebone machines, to creating the virtualized Dockers and Kubernetes and stuff, and then orchestration with Kubernetes. We did complete ELK stack analytics, and also we did the performance engineering as well for this leading payments provider in the US, who is similar to our NPCI, National Payments Corporation of India, implementing the Unified Payments Platform, UPF. And this basically where we had to use multiple different toolkits, and we had to scale up a lot, train our own people, convert our people into more into digital workforce. And then this was one of the early engagements where we had to walk through a lot of fire and ensure that we help the customer. So we had to do all these kind of POCs, as Amitabh Bratty said. The very important thing is to ensure that we, before we stand up before the customer, you do your homework and you do all these things internally. You validate so that you don't waste customers' money and time. So we did all the POCs, we did all these things in our own environment, and then we developed our own continuous Q environment called continuous Q itself. And this CQI, we call it CQ internal, we use that as the building a block or the platform for nurturing our skills. And then we actually help the customer in onboarding their application so that we don't have any challenges. And we did a smooth conversion of their existing infra into IAC and complete dockerization of their solutions and stuff. And the team is still, it's a continuous journey, and we still do some of the performance engineering stuff for the same customer. And the solution is basically to implement the whole DevOps, DevSecOps, plus onboarding the applications into the system, and also do the continuous testing and stuff, so that the customer benefits are that they could actually get the rapid deployment time, scalability, vertical and horizontal scalability, and the CA efficiency, and also the standardization on various different environments, so that more projects then they came to us, and then from the same customer onboarding into their system. And it became a kind of norm, so that we started onboarding every month one or two systems into their platforms, Jenkins platform. So not just only the setting up the digital journey with the continuous testing, continuous deployment, but also the help the customer in terms of complete performance engineering from a meager 200 transactions per second to 2000 transactions per second. We were able to clock it, and we not only did the performance testing or scalability testing, but also help the customer in terms of performance engineering and fine-tuning their databases, fine-tuning their web services, web servers, and mainly their backend servers to ensure that we achieve the objective of 2,000 transactions per second, because the customer was gearing up for the 5G swarming. And when the 5G swarming happens, the customer wanted in to ensure that their application looks good, and there's no lack of delay. So this is where actually we moved on from a millisecond or a millisecond kind of like environment to a kind of more into microseconds. In fact, the nanosecond capabilities of JMeter, we have to clock for individual containerized service, so that we could actually report in nanoseconds, so that we can actually take more transactions per second and make the system more efficient and use less cloud resources and cloud compute capability, so that it increases the profitability of the customer, because they have to implement it in various different customer bases, this platform. So this is one good example of how we can help, how we help the complete performance engineering, complete onboarding of digital services into QA, into continuous quality environment and stuff. So this is one K8S service implementation that we did for the US customer, which is a payments provider.
Just a quick one, Raja, before you, we move. So this is sure. to you only, Raja. In terms of automation in the testing space,
yeah,
I mean, you spoke, I mean, I'm not referring to the ones where you customize it for any particular client, but the tools that are available, if you can give us a little bit of a overview in terms of what are the key tools that are available that would be available to for any customer to use in terms of automation now.
Sure, yeah. We love open source, and we have been helping our customers in open source, and mainly because now open source landscape has increased a lot. Selenium is one good solution that we have been using a lot in the past. And now that we have Cypress, which is for the, especially when it comes to speed and some of the customers who demand more speed and a more in-depth solution in terms of a workable solution in terms of time to market. And when Selenium is slow, we suggest Cypress as well for JavaScript-based solutions such as MonStack, GreenStack, Flutter, and any JavaScript and TypeScript-based solutions, we prefer Cypress as well, because which is actually a in-process automation solution compared to Selenium. And more nowadays, we are doing more of our own solution called AutoQBA, which is a complete solution in terms of continuous integration and the entire end-to-end test automation. Plus, we also love this robot framework, which we have been lately finding it very, very interesting and complete solution in terms of a framework, which is not just a simple test automation framework, but it takes care of the whole nine yards. So we use the robot framework as well a lot. And apart from these solutions, we lately found that JMeter and API-based testing is also a very important step. Yeah. So we see the whole application gamut, application landscape as a spear. And if you cut across the spear, the two hemispheres, the surface of the hemisphere, you will see API. So what we wanted to do is that we suggest API testing, complete API testing using JMeter, or REST Assured, or using Postman or Newman, which is actually Postman's client, terminal client. We use all these solutions to do the API testing. We also have developed our own API solution and API test automation framework to speed up the entire API testing into multi-threaded API cases, because existing solutions like REST Assured do not are not multi-threaded. So we developed our own REST-Q multi-threaded API solution as well. So all these things are basically to speed up the whole time to market and do not waste the time in terms of testing the edge cases, which are actually the end user GUI cases. While GUI cases are important, but we can approach the testing better with API testing and reduce the GUI cases and do that as a kind of sparingly. We can use the test automation using GUI, using Selenium or Cypress as edge cases, whereas the main ground is covered through API testing. So that's where we approach this, and there are plenty of solution API solutions available that we can actually use for this purpose as well.
Okay, super. We can go.
I think a very relevant point which Jaja just mentioned about, I mean, I can just quickly add this in terms of, you know, usually we look at, you know, people looking at multiple tools to kind of do testing to show comprehensiveness in the testing. I think what's important is to choose the right tool and have the right testing mechanism available, so that you don't really overboard. And I think that's what Raja was alluding to. And I think that plays a very, very important, not from a timing perspective as well, but also from an accuracy perspective.
So, Amitabh, is it that, you need some automated tool to
absolutely
validate
absolutely
the results? Would an organization look at that for validation, not just the manual aspect, but even an automated results coming out of an automated tool?
Absolutely. Not only automation, or I would say, is important from testing perspective, but also getting the testing data available as well. I think that plays a very, very crucial role in terms of having the right set of data available for testing as well. So automation works well for both the cases, not only in testing, but also making sure that testing data is available as well.
Very true, very true. Yes. So that's where actually we develop solutions, Amitabh, which can automatically create that synthetic data.
Yeah.
And we also use solutions like Mockeroo and test.ai and stuff like that. But more than that, we generate our own randomized test data solution. And that ensures that referential integrity automatically takes care of the referential integrity, so that we populate the database through the front-end message, the front-end systems, so that the referential integrity is not lost. That is one major challenge our customers face in terms of test data management. How do we ensure that we take out the island of data, which is subsetting the data from production, and ensuring that the referential integrity are within that set, and ensuring that we do not need to work with the entire data from production, which is a huge volume. That's a very good point, Amitabh, actually. Test data
thank management. You, thank you. Go on, Raj.
So similarly, this is another solution that we did for one of the leading card provider. This company provides, it's not a financial customer, so I can't tell the name, a confidentiality, but this company provides a solution for card services companies like MasterCard and Visa, and they provide the platform for the card management, card embossing, and the complete card management solution. And where we build the complete QA and QE, especially when it comes to test automation and the complete building of the entire solution and making it completely a DevOps based and continuous integration, continuous testing. So again, this is fully, as you can see, the same, our favorite solutions like Selenium, JMeter, and UFT will be there. Micro Focus is a very good partner for us. We have been using UFT also, which helps in terms of many of the mainframe-based solutions where we use both for legacy modernization, where we have to do a lot of mainframe-related stuff, 3270 or 5250 clients, we use UFT. And also, we have developed our own keyword-based solution for TN5250 and TN3270-based solutions as well for both Selenium and JMeter. And we have been using those solutions for this customer because their main, as you know, most of the Base24 and most of the solutions which are related to the cards and the payments are highly relying on the mainframe. And mainframe code scanning, mainframe SCA, COBOL SCA, and COBOL automation, mainframe automation is very, very important for us as well. And this is one way that we help the customers to understand the kind of legacy that they have and how do we actually modernize them with the API front ends and providing kicks endpoints for the customers who are using mainframes and stuff like that to modernize their solutions, starting with the kicks and providing API-based solutions, which is actually wrapping around the mainframe services. So in this particular case, we have been completely providing the continuous testing environment and continuous testing Docker systems and stuff and Jenkins, and also the QE part, performance engineering and complete analytics using ELK for this customer. And the benefit is that they got 50% reduced in terms of testing spends. And we most of the time are basically, we always try to ensure that we transfer our learnings, transfer our work to the customer so that they can continue their operations. And we can actually, once we implement the solution, we get the complete training for the customers so that we can come out and the customers can continue and with the less number of people and they can onboard their solutions on their own. So this is something that we did for this customer. We showed them how to do continuous queue, our own XPO solution pipeline, which is our framework for continuous automation, and how we can do not just DevOps, but DevSecOps, including DevOps plus security and performance. And this is where actually we were able to get 70% faster test execution because we were able to do, we used the same solution for test automation as well performance testing, like JMeter-based test API testing. Since we use JMeter, we were able to reuse the same scripts for performance testing as well, which is reducing in the amount of time required for creating the test performance test scripts and stuff like that. So this is another execution, another complete engagement on the continuous testing and continuous QA for the digital journey for the customer.
So Amitabh, I mean, you know, obviously a lot of these tools are used and a lot of the libraries are created, but how much is organizations like MasterCard or banks actually reusing these internally? Because, or you just depend on external partners to come and supplement every QA effort?
So two answers to your question, Murtaza. I mean, one is obviously, I mean, the set of testing which happens within the organization itself depends a lot in terms of, you know, reusability. So we definitely look at, whenever we look forward to invest in a tool, we definitely look in terms of, you know, what's the long-term use and how do we continue using that. So I think that's something which is definitely in perspective. But we also look in terms of, you know, when we work with partners in validation space or in testing space, I mean, we definitely look in terms of, you know, the capability or the library which the partners also have, so that, you know, there are more often than not, you have scenarios wherein you have to go back and look at what was done in the past, and then you are building on top of it. So the synchronization in terms of tools plays a very, very important role when you work with those partners. So I think that sums to your question, sort of.
Yeah, because, you know, nowadays, a lot of these tools are left behind, right?
Yeah,
by the partners.
Right.
And for the organizations to then take it on.
Right.
But as you said, are the skill sets in place within the organization to actually benefit from those tools and library of cases?
So again, at least from the financial services piece, you know, the new set of people who are joining now, they definitely do not have. I mean, those skill sets seems to be becoming difficult to find. But yeah, I mean, we still have set of people who are still, I would say, holding ground and anything else. And we are able to kind of transfer the knowledge in some way or the other. But I think what you said is absolutely right. The new set of people who are coming in, there's definitely a challenge, obviously, because people are also moving on in terms of testing space as well. So the tool, the technology which is used now to develop things is different than what it was there in the past. So obviously, there's a challenge for sure.
Super. Thank you, Amitabh. Raja, you have...
Thank you, Amitabh.
Yeah.
So similarly, this is one thing
PhD. I want
to show you about the PSD2 success story. This is for one of the largest bank in the Europe and French bank in the Europe, and where we have been helping them in terms of a complete API-based test automation. And as you can see, the tools that I mentioned, like Postman, SoapUI, Selenium, all this stuff, Capybara.
Raja, I must stop you for a minute. You know, whoever is naming these tools, I think deserves creativity award. You know, you have amazing names, Postman, Capybara. There were some previous, I mean, they sound so much more exotic probably than they are.
They are amazing tools as well. They are amazing.
I'm sure.
Yeah, sorry. JMeter is one of the industry standard, gold standard tool. And similarly, LoadRunner was actually, until JMeter was born, LoadRunner was the gold standard, and it was able to do most of the load and from various different solutions, various different technologies. Now, JMeter is actually open source and is able to do an equally decent job in terms of expect for the visualization and augmentation of the reports. We can actually achieve a lot of reporting and samplers, a lot of custom samplers also you can define. And these are the solutions that we use to help our customers. For example, for one of the banks in Philippines, we had to develop a solution for a complete mainframe backend and performance testing for mainframe. Typically, customers do not ask for performance testing for mainframes because mainframe is huge and they can increase the ration. And this customer wanted to ensure that judicial use of their MIPS, a million instruction per second, the measure that is used in mainframe for the rationing their performance. And this customer wanted to ensure that whether my system is working properly and is it judicially using the mainframe MIPS properly. So which is where we have developed, we use JMeter, we flux the muscles of JMeter, we develop our own sampler. We combine that with a tool called TN5250 and TN3270. Which is a terminal services client, client for 3270. And where we have actually combined this tool chain of JMeter plus TN5 3270, so that the mainframe performance testing could be done. That's a separate case study, of course. And that's the power of these open source solutions, Mithuza. So we can not just, it's not just like a brick, a proprietary brick. It's a very good flubber or a kind of good mold, and we can create new tools out of it, and we can satisfy the customer on their requirements. So that's one thing that we love, tool chaining, and this is a very good example where we used these tools, Postman, JMeter, and stuff for this pack. In this case, PSD2 success story, where we have to use all these API solutions for simulation of APIs. One of the major challenges is that many of these API calls are basically costly. Like say, for example, our Aadhaar API is not available all the time. The banks are rationed all the time because the Aadhaar servers are always busy. So every bank is given only 2 hours. So within the 2 hours, you have to do testing. Similarly, we have got this payment APIs and the PSD2 related APIs or the third party APIs, which involves a lot of cost. So what we had done is we had studied the APIs without using any fancy test virtualization service virtualization solution. We have used the basic Postman and stuff like that to study the APIs and simulate their API outcomes and create a good amount of like database of the responses and parameterize those responses, ensure that these responses are simulated when the testing team asks for some data. And we use this service virtualization for testing data at the same time for the API testing as well. So this is one of the major challenge virtualization. Other one is basically the lack of front-end tool for the web and OAuth and also the API services, which also we have solved. by providing the solution. We provided the complete end-to-end test automation covering the web front, API, and the mainframe tool, because that's the solution that we provided using a BDD kind of framework and Cucumber BDD kind of framework. And we use Selenium and automation solution and APM for mobile and Node.js for, and then the TE3270, which is the terminal emulator for 3270 client for mainframe, so that we could actually simulate all these things automatically. So we used, we achieved this by using AutoCue, our AutoCue BA solution, combining all this data around it actually. So this is where actually we could actually provide a complete lights out continuous iterative regression testing across layers, across say the tiers of the applications in a multi-tier application. And this was actually, we achieved the complete BDD framework using Cucumber and Ruby as well. So this is one solution that was really appreciated by the customer, where they had heterogeneous systems, multiple tiers, mainframe, mobile. So we had the whole gamut of different technology of heterogeneous applications, and we were able to bind them together and create end-to-end test automation so that you test from the mobile and you validated the mainframe on the next step, or you test in the web front end and you validate on the mainframe DB2 directly and stuff like that. So this is something like a good epitome of end-to-end test automation with continuous integration using Jenkins. Okay, so that's about it for this particular case.
Yeah, just a quick closing question to you, Raja. So obviously during COVID times and more out of necessity than anything, the testing moved on to a remote model, right? You were doing remote testing.
Correct.
Now, obviously, things are changing slowly, but you think you're at the point where it will continue to remain mobile, or are we again moving back to a hybrid kind of environment?
No, we are actually, there are innovative solutions nowadays available. We also use some of these like crowd testing, where test crow and similar kind of services for, especially when it comes to mobile, various different types of mobile testing. We have started using some crowd-based testing solutions as well. And moreover, we have very good partners, likes of TestPlan, Xplan, where they are providing this complete mobile services. And we set up the complete mobile testing and mobile lab. And this mobile testing lab contains multiple different devices, which can be remotely operated, and we provide both virtual at the same time physical mobile devices, and we could actually use operate this with various different mobile front ends such as APM testing tool, or using our other good partner called we are using this solution of basically for test automation solutions as well. Those basically help us to do the complete mobile front end testing. So test partners, mobile partners like our Eggplant and TestPlant and APM, we are able to achieve all this kind of stuff actually. So that's basically one thing. Other thing is that nowadays, if you see the overall testing, even for simulating the basic mobile screens and stuff, Chrome itself has multiple different applications, testing solutions. So we use some of these simulations as well for the screen layouts and stuff as also. So these are the kind of solutions that we have been using for mobile automation. And it has been really helpful for our customers.
Amitabh, any closing comments from your end? You're almost done with time.
Yeah, so I mean, I would just say that, you know, remote working would continue, whether testing otherwise. I think it was more important to have the collaboration tools being available, and that serves a purpose, is what I would say. In the scenario where we're in today, and how we go in terms of a more hybrid model as days progress. But having the right set of collaboration tool available between the development team and the testing partners would be a very important thing. I think functional testing, as we say, would continue to be as much important as possible. Wherever the user experience comes in, is I think where there would be some challenges, which is what we would have to address with the collaboration tools available.
Thank you so much. I guess our time's up, and I think we've gone through an interesting hour. We've seen a lot of use cases. Amitabh, thank you so much for your expert opinion on QA as far as your experiences in payments and banks are concerned. So thank you very much, Raja. It was enlightening as usual, and we hope to see you soon again. Thank you very much, both of you.
Thanks a lot, Amitabh. Thanks for your time. Really appreciate it. Valued customer. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.